The year was 1935 EC. Two powers controlled the continent. In the east, the sun rose over the autocratic East European Imperial Alliance, otherwise known as the Empire. In the west, a network of loosely allied democracies formed the Atlantic Federation. Both powers depended on a precious mineral, ragnite, for their survival. And its growing scarcity led to the inevitable, war. Hostilities began in the east when the Empire aggressively crossed their western border. The Atlantic Federation responded, and the Second European War was on. The Empire, with its vast military superiority, struck hard, gaining ground in early victories and putting the Federation on the defensive. Emboldened by their progress and momentum, the Empire set their sights beyond the borders of the Federation. In neighboring Gallia, a peaceful principality along the sea, they found their next victim. Gallia had long maintained its neutrality in the tensions between the two superpowers. But the rich stores of ragnite under the Gallian soil proved too tempting for the Empire. It amassed troops along the eastern border and invaded with all the force of an avalanche. Prologue. Gallia to Arms. March, 1935. Outside the Gallian border town of Brule. Residents are leaving the town before the invasion, headed inland towards the capital.
I haven't been down this road in years. It really hasn't changed very much. Whoa! Already? Hey there, guys! You're beautiful. Starting early this year. You're heading upstream, huh? How's the water?
Freeze! Put your hands in the air. Slowly. Haven't seen you around before. What's your name?
My name's Welkin. And you are...
The one with the gun. We're with the Brule Town Watch. I'm Alicia. Alicia Melchiot. So, I'm wondering what you've been writing in that little book you've got there. Imperial spies are in the area.
This book is nothing, really. I was just sketching the fish and, you know...
Yes. Oh, I know. And you know there's a war on, don't you? All right then, Mr. Artist. We'll talk about fish sketching down at the station. Take him away.
Thanks, fish.
Flowers, bugs, and fish. You're not bad with a pen, are you? I have to say, they're really very good.
Thank you. So you see, I really was just sketching.
Maybe. Or this could be some kind of secret code, and I intend to take my time finding out for sure.
Great.
Welks? Is that you?
Isara! Oh, your timing is perfect.
What have you gotten yourself into now, Welkin? Wait. Don't you live at the old general's house?
That's right. I'm General Gunther's daughter, Isara.
You do know everyone's supposed to evacuate, right?
Yes, I'm aware of that. My brother's here to help me move to the capital, but that may be difficult. I mean, unless you're willing to let him go, that is.
Huh?
I apologize, but I was just doing my job, you know. I saw you with the notebook and thought you were a spy. Again, I'm really sorry about that.
Thanks. Don't worry about it. I can see how I might have looked a little suspicious.
Welks has a real passion for observing nature. That's why he's studying it at the university, right?
Guilty as charged. I get so into it sometimes I forget where I am or that somebody might be watching me.
Gunfire! Everyone, keep your heads down!
Over there!
Come on!
Welkin, you can handle a gun, right?
Yeah. I mean, I made it through training anyway.
Well, they're probably just a small scouting team. We should be able to take them out.
I'm with you.
Okay, here's the plan. Let's get started.
I see three of them.
That's three too many. Stay sharp. Listen a second. There's something I should explain.
Here we go. Yes!
Ah!
go. Yes! Here we go. Here we go.
I don't see any more of them.
Miss Melchiot, there's no other sign of the enemy.
Good. Now, go keep watch and stay alert.
Yes, ma'am. What should we do with the bodies, ma'am?
We'll bury them. So it's begun. I'll do whatever it takes to protect the people of this town. I'll do it, even going to war. I'll do it. What are those?
Seeds from the lion's paw. It blooms white, small, simple, and strong.
I want to be able to remember, once the war is over, that it wasn't all just people killing people. That even in war, there was also new life.
On the 15th day of the third month of the year 1935, the Empire began its assault in earnest. A formal declaration of war was made upon Gallia. Though it was only a small front in a massive continental assault, what followed would prove that a tiny nation could best a military giant. These events would tell a story of tragedy hidden in the mists of time. A story of courage and of trust, of persecution and hate. And of love blooming even through the flames of war. What follows is a record of this conflict and of those who fought, lived, and died. Chapter 1, In Defense of Brule.